Welcome to Gord Field here in Detroit Rock City, home of the Motor City Maniacs. I see the Maniac fans are trying to get the fire wave going. But so far, just a small number of fires and mostly just on the upper deck.
Yeah, they really stepped up security, Grim. In the men's room earlier, I only witnessed 3 random assaults and 2 of them were on me. Not bad for gang day.
Remember, in the MFL, we encourage you to play with your food. He's probably lining up against you. The Midway Mutants battle the Motor City Maniacs. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Are you ready for some MFL action?
Am I? I love MILFs. Mutants I'd like to fuck.
He said MFL, not MILF, you half-wit.
Ow! I thought you were talking about the Mayhem Bowl halftime MILF lingerie girls team. What a zombie QB with that big rack of ribs and almost no waist at all. Ho-ho! Va-va-va-boom!
And it's 1st and 10. Picks up maybe 4 on that play. Second down and 6.
First down! He hit that line the way a rolled up dollar bill sticking out of flimsy Lohan's nose. It's a mare in Lost Wages, Nevada.
And it's 1st and 10. Reels that one in for a 1st down to keep the drive alive. And it's 1st and 10. I love this dirty trick. B5-4-5. Oh, he almost broke that one wide open.
Hey, speaking of breaking one wide open, who's sitting on the oil rig about to blow? Hey, smells like an oven baked port-a-john in here. We're a freaking fracking accident waiting to happen. Don't nobody light a match.
Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it too. And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. Comes the most underrated position in football, the mighty punter. And that punter gets paid way too much to kick like that. They just let that one drop and played safe, and the defense says, we'll take it. And it's 1st and 10. Defense better watch out. The quarterback just threw a murder ball.
I love the murder.
And he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the 1st down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the 3rd set of hands he's had shown on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
One, two.
You know, this berserk dirty trick ain't fair to the QB. It's...
Oh, now the offense is getting kills.
This is a really violent game, guys. It's bad.
First and 10. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About 3:15, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
And he rumbles into the end zone for the score.
Score.
And if you don't understand Second down, and the offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. Talk about butterfingers. He should have had that one. Third down, and the offense needs a miracle. Oh, man, what a throw. That sonic touchdown. Isn't the devil, Brick, just one of them.
Oh, that don't make it any less scary.
And they line up for the extra point. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads.
And he just slipped away like a greased pig. And it's first and ten.
Balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
And he runs it in for the touchdown.
Hey, man, nobody can touch you with that ball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about?
And here comes the extra point attempt. Right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
First and ten.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
And it's first and ten. Caught for the first down. First and ten.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat off rim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage.
So was that cheerleader.
Bring up second and one. And the crowd goes wild. Touchdown! Touchdown! Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
Straight through the uprights. The best kind of kick is guys when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's gonna have the eye, and this game is up for grabs. Second down and four. Third and four. Oh, man, the defense brought a sack once today. Hey, hey, don't eat him. Not until he's cooked. Sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. And he put all of his foot into that one. And he's got a chance for a good return here. And he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
And it's first and ten. Can't blame him. Any field goals over 40 yards are difficult. He's going to really have to boom this one. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And it's first and ten. And they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. First down and forever. The defender says, I don't think so. Second down in a mile. And a nice pass for a 10-yard gain.
It's not a first down in the stat line, but it's a first down in a
Third down, and the punter is warming up. And he was stuck to him like glue. Now here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss this. And he snags the punt and looks for open field. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're going to hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor.
Finish him.
And it's first and ten. About a 6-yard gain.
Hey, do me a favor. If my parole officer calls, I was with you last night, Bricks.
No problem. I spent the night in lockup for solicitation.
Warning. And they'll line up for the punt here. And he booted a high arcing rainbow. He's got the ball now and is going to try and score. Ooh, that hit's going to shave a few days off his life. First and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Hot. The coach said the offense was going to be explosive this week. Oh, hold everything. Looks like there's a penalty on the play. Try and stay in this game.
Oh, nice coaching move there. Hall of Fame caliber.
Well, I mean, it's a pretty standard coaching move at this point of the game.
I won't listen to this blasphemy.
Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely.
Well, that's two timeouts burned. And you have to wonder, Bricks, are they desperate or are they in control?
I'm speaking from experience, Grim, but it really is hard to do both at the same time. And I have mastered it.
And that was a perfect pass, and he scores handily. They're going for 2 points. Points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. And it's first and ten. And he looks looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
Yeah, sounds like my off.
Smart move there, stopping the clock with their first time out.
And for all you know, maybe he's just stalling or wiring the ref some cash.
And the offense goes into their two-minute drill.
Which coincidentally happens to be Brick's match stuffing time.
That's why the girls call me Speedy Gonzalez.
You've got to catch that. The offense goes into their two-minute drill.
What the hell is that?
It's the same thing as a hurry-up offense, you moron.
I am so confused.
And he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can see that, Grim.
And the offense goes into a hurry-up to pick up the pace of the game. Defense has the receivers covered well. That's a 3-yard gain on that pass. The second quarter comes to a close as the teams head for the locker room, and we take you to halftime. Brought to you by Monsanto Industries. We make genetically engineered food that is to die for. It's the start of the third quarter, and we are set to go, Bricks.
Oh, boy! Where are we going, Grim? A carnival? We're gonna go to a striptease show. Where are we going?
Hey, why don't you settle down? Just pet your rabbit, Lenny. Just pet your rabbit. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He's gonna be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
Jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not gonna take it anymore. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. Takes a break from knitting on the sidelines to come in and punt.
His knitting is superb, Grim. That cross-stitching, unbelievable.
He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
Caught for a first down. And it's first and 10. yards on that pass. Second down and two. Shoveled his feet so well on that play, he should go to lost wages and deal cards. First down! And it's first and 10. Oh, big catch! Big run! Big touchdown! And the ref is picking up a wad of singles as he runs off the field.
Didn't you see him stripping on the sidelines? He's primed, you idiot.
And this is the first, and offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. We should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were gonna tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed, it was a chip wearing.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
And that's a pass that went nowhere.
Oh, that's like me at the hotel bar every night.
Hey, maybe you need a better opening line than you want to see the teeth growing out of the roof of my mouth.
What? The book How to Pick Up Girls and Tell Them Something Unique About Yourself. That's unique.
Nice pickup for 6 yards. Third down and 3. There's no reason to drop the ball if you're still alive. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? And it's first and 10. A catch for a 10-yard gain. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made into dice Grim. It'll be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. First down and 7. The third quarter has ended, and we'll need a huge rally or a high death toll to make this one interesting. First down and 7. Second down and 9.
Personally, I think the ginormous guy.
He took a leap and had the ball knocked out. Fumble.
He's got a case of fumbleitis.
And he finds open spaces running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
The 30. He's at the 20. He's at the 10. Touchdown. He ran through those defenders like a greased turkey.
Actually, he does have some turkey skin wrapped on his backside from that bad burn he had last year.
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't say that to first.
Now, this should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Oh, nice hit. And it's 1st and 10. Just blew up a player who thought he was going to score. Oh, that hot potato dirty trick gets him every time. And it's 1st and 10.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not your own.
And it's 1st and 10. Friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. And that'll be 2nd and 8 to go. He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone.
Except maybe self-doubt, but he seems to have worked through it.
Nice and easy, like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
And it's 1st and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a 1st down. And it's 1st and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
And the ball razors through the defense, cutting a defender in half.
That means you can wrap up the other half and save it for...
Boom!
Okay.
and one.
Hot two.
The QB decides to throw the ball away. First down.
Hot one, hot two.
And the QB might as well just bury himself now because this guy's full of
it. Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it too.
Second down in a very lot.
Hot one, hot two.
That pass play nets them 7 yards. Mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and 10. Great run for a 9-yard gain. And that'll bring up second and 1. Two-minute warning sound.
Sounds like what, Grim?
Sounds like the asshole I'm living on.
Third down and 5. And that's how you run the football. First down. They quickly call a timeout, hoping to save some time for their offense. First and 10. Oh, with the brutal hit. The defense is leaving the team with just one timeout, so they better bring the ball back gift wrapped.
Is it time for a ribbon or a ball, Grim?
Maybe if they use their last timeout. And no more timeouts. The D needs to stop. This is intense.
No, Grim. Camping is intense. Get it?
Idiot.
Third down, and the punter is warming up. Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. And he's got a chance for a good return here. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit?
one out of the air for a first down. See if they can get something going here.
Hot one, hot two.
Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. Oh, and did he just put on a display there? Touchdown!
Yo, seriously, man, you think you'd go toe-to-toe with me? I will wreck your world. You understand me, Junior? I'll wreck your world.
I like this. They're going for two. Forward for the two-point conversion.
Yo, man, nobody can touch what I want. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
They need a good return here to set up the offense. They're going to be able to return this one. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by ComCrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you're not happy.